Defense Updates has reached 200,000 subscribers. We cannot thank you enough. We promise to keep delivering interesting content.
Follow us on social media. Support us on Patreon. All links in description below.
Russia recently grabbed a bunch of publicity for its new SU-57 fifth generation jet by sending a pair of these supposedly stealth fighters to practice dropping bombs in Syria. But it looks like the F-35 could squash the program in its infancy. Multiple experts recently told Business Insider that Russia's program to acquire and field the SU-57 desperately needs an infusion of cash from an international investor like India. Initially, India was a partner in the SU-57 program and intended to help develop, build, and eventually buy scores of the advanced fighter jet pitched as a rival to the US F-22 and F-35. But those talks soured and Russia never saw the money. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes why F-35 could dismantle Russia's SU-57 stealth jet program without even firing a shot.
Number 5.
The SUKHOI SU-57 is fifth-generation, stealthy, single-seat, twin-engine jet multi-role fighter aircraft designed for air superiority and ground attack operations. It's the successor of the SU-35 and Russia's answer to American F-35 Lightning II and F-22 Raptor. The SU-57 is the first operational aircraft in Russian Air Force service to use stealth technology. Weapons are carried internally in weapons bays within the airframe, and antennas are recessed from the surface of the skin to preserve the aircraft's stealthy shape. Also, radar absorbent material, RAM, has been used to reduce its radar return, which makes it difficult to detect. SU-57 is designed to have extreme maneuverability at both supersonic and subsonic speeds. It can supercruise with the ability to reach speeds of up to Mach 2 without an afterburner. With its onboard Belka radar station, consisting of 5 radars, provides SU-57 with 360-degree coverage. The SU-57 is speculated to have the ability to detect stealth aircraft and track over 10 targets simultaneously. The SU-57 has 2 large internal weapons compartments, taking up practically the entire useful length of the aircraft, which are capable of carrying a multitude of air-to-air and air-to-ground weapons. It can carry weapons in external hardpoints also.
Number 4.
An SU-57 prototype known as T-50 first flew on the 29th of January 2010, and this is the first time the fighter's been deployed. Russia has often used Syria as a showroom for new hardware, and it most likely wants to market the SU-57. This is especially important for the Indian market in light of the joint Russian-Indian Sukhoi HAL Hindustan Aeronautics Limited 5th Generation Fighter Aircraft FGFA program. The public launch of the SU-57 last year and its deployment to Syria could be aimed at convincing the Indians that FGFA is a real project, which has a prototype that not only flies but is capable of operating in a war zone. Experts now believe that Russia's deployment of the underdeveloped, underpowered fighters to Syria, a combat zone where they're hardly relevant as air superiority fighters not facing any real air threats, was a marketing ploy to get more investment. Russia has ordered only 12 of the SU-57s, not even enough for a full squadron. The Russian economy is a mess. Retired U.S. Air Force Lieutenant General David Deptula, now head of the Mitchell Institute for Aerospace Studies, told Business Insider. One of the things they can actually get money for is the advanced tech in their weapon systems. But with the SU-57 seeming like a long shot with trouble ahead, and the F-35 now ready to buy, the Trump administration's expressed strategy of punishing the Kremlin cash flow with military sales might bear fruit.
Number 3.
While Russia rushed off the SU-57s for a deployment that lasts mere days and demonstrates only that these supposedly next-generation fighters can drop bombs, the U.S. has made real inroads selling the F-35 to countries that might have looked at the SU-57. The U.S. sent F-35s to the Singapore Air Show in February as part of an international sales pitch. President Donald Trump's administration has loosened up regulations on who the U.S. can sell weapons to, and the F-35, once a troubled program, finally seems to have hit a stride.
Number 2.
Japan and South Korea are both thinking about buying more F-35s, but most importantly, the diplomat rounded up several reports indicating that India's Air Force formally requested a classified briefing on the F-35A. The United States has not formally offered the aircraft to India, and any classified briefing would require clearance by the U.S. Department of Defense and the U.S. Department of State. As per reports, the Indian Air Force would possibly be interested in procuring up to 126 F-35As from the United States as a deal for 126 French-made Dassault Rafale multi-role fighter aircraft fell through, and India procure 36 Rafale fighters in flyaway condition. At around $100 million per airframe, such a purchase would likely leave little room in the budget for India to buy SU-57s, which would require vastly different support infrastructure than the U.S. jet.
Number 1.
F-35's export to countries, especially India, posed a threat to Russia's SU-57 program. If India decided to buy F-35s or really any Western jet, Russia would have its struggling SU-57 and one fewer customer for it and won't have enough investment to keep the SU-57 program going. So while jet enthusiasts have long debated who would win in a fight between the F-35 and the SU-57, we may never find out. The U.S.'s F-35 is a real jet that has significant money behind it to keep it flying in air forces across the globe for decades to come. Russia's SU-57 has no such security.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting. And kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.